From historic downtown Waco, deep in the heart of Texas, this is First Sunday Morning, a ministry of the First Baptist Church of Waco. A part of our community, celebrating fellowship together and sharing ministry with others through the timeless good news of the gospel story of new life in Christ Jesus.
Church family, welcome to church on Pentecost Sunday. We have a word of welcome from our pastors from the Korean Church of Waco, our Spanish service, and First Baptist Waco.
Good morning. This is a beautiful Sunday morning, and we are celebrating Pentecost Sunday. This morning, I thought we could have been totally stranger to each other, but we are here together to worship God, no matter what language, no matter what ethnic identity. So welcome and thank you for being with us this morning.
Qué bendición estar todos juntos aquí unidos con el único propósito de dar la gloria y la honra a nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Sean bienvenidos.
Friends, if you're our guest today, we'd like to invite you to find the worship guide and fill out the section where we request your information. We're going to try to sell you things and embarrass you personally. No, I'm just kidding. We would like to get to know you better. So when the offering plate comes around later in the service, you can place that in there or meet us in the foyer after the service and we'll exchange that for a gift. Now, if you would please rise and greet the people around you as we begin worship today. Friends, I'd like to invite you to find your places again and find your seats. We welcome to the pulpit this morning Pastor George Zamora of the Buffalo River Indian Baptist Church. Pastor George will read our text from today from Acts chapter 2. Pastor George.
When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place of one accord. Suddenly a sound of the blowing of a violent wind filled the whole house. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Now, there were staying in Jerusalem God-fearing Jews of every nation under heaven, and when they heard the sound, a crowd came together in bewilderment, because each one of them heard them speaking in his own language. Utterly amazed, they all asked, "Are not these men who are speaking Galileans? Then how is it that each of us hears them speaking in our own language? Parthians, Medes, Edomites, residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, Egypt, and parts of Libya near Cyrene, visitors from Rome, both Jews and converts from Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, we hear them declaring the wonders of God in our own language and our own tongues. Amazed and perplexed, they asked one another, what does this mean? Some, however, made fun of them and saying, they've had too much wine. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice and addressed the crowd, fellow Jews, and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you and listen carefully to what I say. These men are not drunk, as you would suppose. It's only 9 in the morning. No, this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and your daughters will prophesy. Your young men shall see visions. Your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. I will show wonders in heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and billows of smoke. The sun will be turned to darkness and the moon into blood. Before the coming of the great and glorious day of the Lord, and everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth was a man accredited by God to you by miracles, wonders and signs which God did among you through him. As you yourselves know, this man was handed over to you by God's set purpose and foreknowledge. And you, with the help of wicked men, put him to death by nailing him on the cross. But God raised him from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to keep his hold about him. Amen. Lord bless it.
Good morning. 안녕하세요. Buenos dias. My name is Moises Park, and I'll be leading a song in three languages. And be ready to get help from the Spirit, as we know. He helps us with languages. I teach languages, but I won't give you a hard time correcting accents or anything like that. This is a time to worship God. We'll do this in English first, and then we'll sing it twice in Spanish. The original song, Tu Fidelidad, was written in Spanish. And with the help of some friends, I was able to translate it into Korean. So the fourth time we'll sing it in Korean. And the last time, it'll be in the language that you prefer. And you don't have to default into English. You can, of course, try it in Spanish or Korean. It goes like this. Your faithfulness.
Your faithfulness is great enough. Your faithfulness is incomparable. There is none like you, O blessed God. Great is thy faithfulness.
Tu fidelidad es grande.
Tu fidelidad es grande. Tu fidelidad es grande, tu fidelidad. Tu fidelidad incomparable es. Nadie como tú, bendito Dios. Grande es tu fidelidad.
Let's try it in Korean. 주는 신실함.
주는 신실하신 하나님 주의 신실함 비교할 수 없네 주님과 같은 분 없네 신실하신 하나님
Your faithfulness, tu fidelidad
tu fidelidad
Yeah.
I'd like to invite the children to join me for the children's message. Good morning. How are y'all doing today? Good. We have some new friends. I'm excited to see you guys joining us today for worship. I also have a new friend right over here, Mr. William. Everyone look around and say, hey, Mr. William. Some of you may call him Bro Love. That's okay, too. So Mr. William is going to help us sing a song that I think most of us know. Okay?
God is so good.
You know that one? That was very good. We're going to sing it one more time, but this time I want us to say, God is so good, he's so good to us. Think we can do that? All right, let's do it again.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to us.
Great job. Now, there are a lot of reasons that God is so good. We could list them all day long, but today is a special Sunday. It's Pentecost Sunday. My buddy Harrison's got a little flame on his head. And today is the day we celebrate that God gives us the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is God with us. So it's how God can help us love others and how God can help us make right choices and things like that. So it's really amazing that God gives us that gift. And that's one reason that God is so good. So today, as we're worshiping, I want you to remember that. Can you remember that? God gives us the Holy Spirit. Let's pray. God, I thank you for each of these precious, precious children who are here this morning to love you and worship you, God. And I thank you especially for giving us the Holy Spirit that is with us each and every day to help us make the right choices and to follow you and to love others the way you would love them. It's in your Son's precious and holy name I pray. Amen.
Sing it in Spanish first, a familiar tune.
Mi Cristo, mi Rey, nadie es como tú, toda mi vida quiero exaltar las maravillas.
All of my days. Let's pray.
Gracias Dios porque estamos aquí una vez más todos juntos. Te pido que bendigas todo lo que se va a hacer hoy y que bendigas la ofrenda que se va a recoger.
Thank you, God, because we are here one more time worshiping your name together. Thank you for everything that you do for us. Please bless everything that is being done today and bless the offering. I pray that it may be used in your name and for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Deep river, my home is over Jordan. Deep river, Lord, I want to cross over into campground. Deep river, my home is over Jordan. Deep river, Lord, I want to cross over into campground.
What a great moment. The Holy Spirit is here. Let's pray. Gracias, Señor, una vez más por esta oportunidad de estar juntos, Señor. Esta experiencia inolvidable, Dios. Te queremos pedir, Señor, por nuestras mentes, por nuestros corazones. En el nombre de Cristo Jesús. Amén. Be seated. Recibir en mi casa invitados es una cosa seria. Consiste desde la limpieza, la preparación de comida y el tiempo de espera.
Receiving guests in my home is always something important. It starts with the cleaning of the house, and then preparing the food, and then the time of waiting.
La encargada de la comida es mi mamá. Nosotros le ayudamos, pero mi mamá es la que pone el sazón en la comida. La espera es muchas veces desesperante por el olor de la comida y el deseo de ya empezar a comer.
The person in charge of the food is my mother. Of course, we always help, but she brings the most important ingredient, the seasoning for the food. The wait at times can be maddening from the smell of food and the desire to begin the meal.
La espera se hace eterno cuando la hora acordada está por terminar. Esta situación de espera sentían los discípulos, desesperados por la llegada prometida.
This wait can feel like an eternity when the designated time arrives. This is the situation in which the disciples found themselves, desperately awaiting the arrival of the one who had been promised.
Imaginémonos esta frase. Todos estaban juntos en un lugar. El tiempo de espera ya había sido semanas.
Let's think about this statement. They were all together in one place. The wait had been weeks at this point.
En el lugar estaban discípulos. Estos hombres que caminaron y que vieron el ministerio de Jesucristo. Algunos de los 70 evangelistas que fueron enviados de dos en dos. Las mujeres que acompañaron a Jesús, las que habían entrado en la tumba y las que no habían encontrado a Jesús.
In this place, the disciples were gathered. The men who had witnessed and walked alongside the ministry of Jesus. Likely some of the 70 evangelists who had been sent two by two to share the good news. The women who had accompanied Jesus and who entered our Lord's tomb to find it empty.
Esta representación grande e imaginable es la que somos partícipes hoy. Estamos todos juntos en un solo lugar. Hombres, mujeres, niños, visitantes, hombres de negocio, doctores, profesores, madres, padres, abuelos.
We're participants today in this great and unimaginable event. We are all gathered here in one place. Men, women, children, visitors, businessmen, doctors, lawyers, professors, mothers and fathers and grandparents.
Este es un día de gozo, de alegría, de felicidad, porque el Espíritu Santo está aquí con nosotros y se está manifestándose.
This is a day of joy, of happiness, and celebration, because the Holy Spirit is here with us manifesting itself today.
La llegada de los invitados en mi familia es un proceso que consiste en ver el tiempo, ver el reloj, contar el tiempo, pensar por qué no han llegado.
The arrival of guests in my family is a process, which begins by watching the clock, counting down the minutes, and wondering where our guests might be.
El sonido de la llegada muchas veces es el timbre de la puerta o una voz.
The sound of their arrival is announced when the doorbell rings or when we hear their voice.
En la casa de mis padres en Ecuador, el sonido de la puerta de metal da inicio que esta persona ha llegado. O la voz de buenos días, de buenas tardes o de buenas noches da la presencia del visitante ha llegado. El sonido de la casa o de mis suegros o de mi casa aquí es el sonido del timbre.
At my parents' home in Ecuador, the sound of the guests arriving is a knock on the metal door and a shout of good morning or good afternoon. At my in-laws' house or at my house here, it's the sound of a doorbell.
Un sonido grande y celestial da la presencia del Espíritu Santo que ha llegado, un estruendo como de un viento recio que sopla, el cual llenó toda la casa, todo el lugar donde estaban sentados.
A grand celestial sound announces the arrival of the Holy Spirit. It's like a rush of violent wind that it filled the entire house where they were sitting.
En esta mañana nosotros estamos sintiendo el Espíritu Santo. Ese viento recio que suena en la puerta de nuestros corazones. Ese viento recio que estremece nuestra alma y nuestra mente.
This morning we feel the presence of the Holy Spirit, this rush of violent wind that echoes on the door of our hearts, that violent wind that shakes our souls and our minds.
Celebremos, el Espíritu Santo está aquí.
Let us celebrate, the Holy Spirit is here.
Nuestros visitantes siempre, cuando llegan a nuestro lugar de vivienda, nos regalan la emoción de verlos, la felicidad de tenerlos en nuestra casa. Dependiendo de la ocasión, los visitantes traen comida o regalos.
Our guests gift us with the excitement of seeing old friends, the joy of having them in our home, and depending on the occasion, they might bring a dessert or a small gift.
Esta llegada del Espíritu Santo trajo regalos, lenguas repartidas como de fuego para cada uno de ellos, llenura para todos y el comienzo para hablar.
The arrival of the Holy Spirit brought gifts as well. Divided tongues of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability.
Hoy nosotros tenemos los regalos que se han repartido a través del Espíritu Santo, palabra, llenura y acción.
Today we have been given the gift of the Holy Spirit. We are filled by the Spirit, given the gift of language, and called to action.
Qué regalo incomparable, qué regalo inimaginable.
What an incomparable and unimaginable gift.
We tend to focus on supernatural phenomenon of Pentecost.
Muchas veces nos enfocamos en la parte supernatural del Pentecostés.
Speaking in tongues, prophecies, visions and dreams.
Hablar en lenguas, ver visiones, profetizar.
But what the Spirit really wanted to do was to declare mighty works of God in every language, that everybody in the city could listen to the gospel message.
Pero lo que realmente el Espíritu quería hacer es demostrar y declarar las maravillas de Dios.
The story surprised them and excited them.
La historia los sorprendió y los emocionó.
And many people believe in God and turn to God.
Y muchos creyeron y siguieron a Dios.
1,000 years ago, people gathered together and built the Tower of Babel to reach heaven.
Miles de años, hace miles de años, personas se juntaron para crear una torre de Babel y llegar al cielo.
They wanted to make a name for themselves.
Querían hacer su nombre.
They were boasting of their story of great adventure, success, and victory.
Querían jactarse y decirles a los otros de sus grandes aventuras, éxitos y victorias.
But God confused their language and they scattered.
Pero Dios creó confusión en su lengua y los divulgó en toda la tierra.
When the Spirit came and proclaimed the mighty works of God, however, people praised God and lift up the name of Jesus.
Cuando el Espíritu llegó y proclamó las maravillas del Señor, muchos alabaron y levantaron el nombre de Jesús.
They humbled themselves, repented their sins, and became the church, the family of God.
Se humillaron, se arrepintieron, y fueron parte de una iglesia y parte de la familia de Dios.
The Spirit of God unites us with the great story of our Lord Jesus Christ.
El Espíritu de Dios nos une y nos cuenta sobre la gran historia de nuestro Señor Jesucristo.
What does being poured out with the Spirit mean then?
¿Qué significa cuando el Espíritu se imparte?
It means that we are deeply thankful for and excited with what God has done in our lives.
Bueno, significa que estamos agradecidos y emocionados que el Señor está y ha hecho en nuestras vidas.
Therefore, it means we desire to share that experience, that news, with the people around us.
Y esa emoción, esa experiencia es la que nosotros queremos compartir con aquellos que están alrededor de nosotros.
Because of Christ, we have been transformed. Our family has gained peace, and we were able to overcome fear and despair.
Por Jesucristo hemos sido transformados, nuestras familias han obtenido paz y hemos podido superar el miedo y la desesperación.
Because of the cross, we are saved and found new hope.
Por la cruz nosotros somos salvos y encontramos gozo y paz.
And because of the Lamb of God, our lives will never be the same.
Y por el Cordero de Dios, nuestra vida nunca será igual.
This is the mighty works of God we wanted to share.
Estas son las maravillas de Dios que queremos compartir.
The Spirit-filled church does not share our success stories.
La iglesia que está llena del Espíritu Santo no solamente comparte las historias de algunos cristianos.
She desires to share the story of God, the story of our Lord Jesus.
El Espíritu realmente quiere compartir la gran y única historia.
Years ago, when I was living in Boston, there were many Korean immigrants who made their living by working in laundry shops.
Cuando yo vivía en Boston, había muchos inmigrantes coreanos que vivían y trabajaban en las lavanderías en Boston.
They were not fluent in English. Often, what they had was just minimum English for survival.
No hablaban muy bien el inglés. Tenían un inglés rudimentario suficiente para tener un negocio y sobrevivir.
When the local American pastor entered the shop to drop off his shirt.
Un día llegó un pastor estadounidense y entró a la lavandería.
The owners of the shop were Korean immigrant couple.
Los dueños de la tienda eran inmigrantes coreanos.
They were hardworking Christians.
Eran cristianos que trabajaban mucho.
It was a hot day and the temperature inside the shop was even higher.
Era un día caluroso y dentro de la tienda de la lavandería era mucho más caluroso.
But the pastor recognized the sound coming from cassette tape player.
Pero ese pastor pudo reconocer una melodía que se estaba tocando con un cassette.
Even though he did not understand the Korean lyric, it was definitely Jesus loved me, this I know.
No entendía lo que decía el coreano, pero sabía que estaba seguro que la letra decía Cristo me ama, la canción.
And at some point of transaction, he found the owners and himself singing the same song in different languages.
Se dio cuenta en algún momento en esta interacción y experiencia que ambos estaban cantando la misma canción en diferentes lenguajes.
Nal 사랑하시 날 사랑하시 날 사랑하시 성경에 써 있네. They exchanged smiles.
Sonrieron.
Yes, they knew how Jesus loved them so much.
Sabían que Cristo los amaba.
They know how much Jesus poured out his life for them.
Y sabían también que Cristo había dado sus vidas por ellos.
Though they sang in different languages and did not understand the language on the other side, they were praising the same God and honoring the same name of Jesus.
Y aunque cantaban en diferentes lenguajes y no entendían el idioma del otro, sabían que ambos alababan a Dios y estaban honrando y recordando el amor sacrificial del Señor Jesucristo.
That makes them brothers and sisters, and this is what the Spirit does when He comes to the church.
Hermanos, esto es lo que pasa cuando el Espíritu está en la iglesia.
The Spirit leads us to tell the mighty works of God.
El Espíritu nos lleva a decir y compartir las maravillas de Dios.
So brothers and sisters, let us follow His lead and share this great news with our neighbors.
Hermanos, hermanas, sigamos su ejemplo y compartamos estas grandes nuevas con nuestros amigos y nuestros vecinos.
And let us lift up the name of Jesus beyond our cultural and ethnic boundaries.
Alcemos el nombre de Jesucristo más allá de la cultura y de nuestro lenguaje.
Then we will find the Spirit make us united as one body and one family of God, as we just experienced.
Y el Espíritu nos podrá unir en un cuerpo y en una familia de Dios como experimentamos.
The Holy Spirit has made us one.
El Espíritu Santo nos ha hecho uno.
That we may proclaim one message.
Que proclamemos un mensaje.
Salvation in Jesus Christ our Lord.
La salvación en Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
In Acts chapter 2.
En Hechos del capítulo 2.
We hear these words.
Escuchamos esta palabra.
And it shall come to pass.
tenía que pasar.
That everyone who calls
que cada uno que sea llamado
upon the name of Jesus
en el nombre de Jesucristo
shall be saved.
Debería ser salvo.
Our deepest need is salvation.
Nuestra necesidad es salvación.
We have the table before us today.
Tenemos la mesa enfrente de nosotros.
Proclaiming the Lord's death until he comes.
Proclamando la muerte de nuestro Señor Jesucristo hasta cuando él venga.
Christ suffered for us.
Jesucristo sufrió por nosotros.
To save us.
Para salvarnos.
And bring us to God.
Y llevarnos a Dios.
My prayer.
Mi oración.
Is that you have received the love of Christ.
Es que recibas el amor de Cristo.
Into your heart.
En tu corazón.
And been changed by it.
Que seas cambiado por eso.
If that is true for you.
Y si esto es verdad para ti.
I pray that the greatest desire in your heart.
Yo oro que eso sea el deseo de tu corazón.
Is to share this message with others.
Que compartas este mensaje con otros.
We can't do this in our own strength.
No podemos hacer en nuestras propias fuerzas.
We cannot do this in our own power.
No podemos hacer en nuestros propios poder.
God never wanted us to.
Dios nunca lo quiso.
He has made us to be a people of prayer.
Él nos ha hecho personas de oración.
That we would humble ourselves before him.
Que nos humillemos ante él.
And meet his power and grace.
Y que conozcamos su poder y su gracia.
Today, before we come to the Lord's table,
hoy cuando venimos a la mesa,
we are going to turn this place, this room,
vamos a llegar a este lugar, a este momento,
into a house of prayer for all nations.
A una casa de oración para todas las naciones.
I'd like to invite you to stand, please.
Les invito a todos que se pongan de pie.
And look around briefly and find three or four people that you could gather with in prayer.
Y encuentra dos o tres personas que están a tu lado y haz un grupo de oración.
Turn toward them now, if you would. Form a circle of prayer. Make sure that no one is left out.
Un círculo de oración.
Your prayer direction is very simple.
La oración dirigida es muy simple.
We ask you to pray for a fresh baptism of the Holy Spirit.
Te pedimos que ores por la Santa Cena.
For this church to be filled with the love of God.
Por esta iglesia para que sea llena del amor.
That we would make his name known.
Que demostremos su nombre.
To our neighbors.
A nuestros vecinos.
And to our nations.
Y a nuestra nación.
Would one of you or two of you in your group voice those prayers aloud, and when your group is finished, please be seated.
Uno o dos de ustedes puede comenzar la oración y cuando se termine, se pueden sentar.
Let us pray now.
Oremos.
sendas.
To invite those that are coming to help serve to come join us now as we come to the Lord's table together. Night of his betrayal, Jesus took bread and he blessed it and he broke it and he gave it to his disciples and he said, eat this in remembrance of me. Today we eat in remembrance of our Lord, Jesus the Christ. God, we thank you for your life and your love. We thank you for your son. We thank you for his sweet gift. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. On the same night, Jesus took a cup. He called it the cup of the new covenant. He gave it to his disciples and told them to drink. He told them that it was a gift for them, for us. Today we give thanks for the precious blood of the Lord, our Savior and King. God, we thank you for the life that was given for our lives. Today we proclaim that hope as we drink this cup together. We pray in Christ's name. Amen. Friends, I'd like to invite you to stand as we sing a great hymn of our faith. This is a hymn of commitment, a hymn of surrender. If you have made decisions in the privacy of your heart and you'd like to make them publicly today, we invite you to come as we sing and pray together. As we sing, Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus.
After this, I looked, and there before me was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, tribe, people, and language, standing before the throne and before the Lamb. They were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." All the angels were standing around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. They fell down on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, saying, "Amen. Praise and glory and wisdom and thanks and honor and power and strength be to our God forever and ever. Amen."